Hey guys, this is Juno with Detour Shirts with another quick tip in Affinity Designer. This tip is about using text on a path. So you can use this text on a path technique for t-shirts like this one right here. You can see how it's on an arc. You can do text on a path on just a squiggly line path, any path that you create, or a shape, any shape that you create. Usually a circle or an oval is what's used the most, but you can do it on any shape. So if you're gonna do a path, you can just draw a path with your pen tool. What you wanna do for text on a path is click on your text tool. Make sure you do the artist text tool right here. And then you're gonna click on the path. And then when you hover over the path, you're gonna see it change from A to T. You see that? A to T. When it's on a T, then click on it and then start typing. So this is text on a path. I'm gonna make it bigger so you can see it. Can see as it grows, it just follows the path, right? And these two handles here, these triangle handles, will move your text. So this is the beginning of your text, and this is the end of your text right here. So if you want to move it in, you see how it moves. I typically, on a path, I would like to do it all the way. So if you don't want it all the way to the left, you can use these right here, center align, and it will center it. If you want it right aligned, you can see right there, and left aligned is the default. So we're gonna use that on the circle one too. So let's do the circle now. So on a circle, again, click on your text, make sure you have the circle selected, wait for that T, click on it, and we're gonna type in Yellowstone. Usually at default, it's so small, unless you're zoomed in. I'm kinda zoomed out, so I'm gonna use something bigger like this. 96. Now I'm going to move these triangles to the edge. So I want to start it there and end it here. You can see that top part of the arc. And I want to center it. So I'm going to center it here. And I want to use a different font. So I'm just going to go here and type in the font that I want. I like that super star font. There you go. And if the text, if two letters are too far away from each other, you can hold down Option and click the left arrow and move it in closer. And if it's too close, you can click the right arrow and move it away. So holding down Option does that. Now let's do the bottom text, this Montana, USA. That's gonna be a little bit different. So the way I'm gonna show you how to do that is, we're just gonna do Command J. You can see both of them here, Yellowstone, Yellowstone. It doesn't matter which one you pick. You can pick the top one or the bottom one, but we're gonna double click on it. You can see I'm doing the top one, and then type Montana. And you can't see it right now, but it's above it. So I'm gonna move these triangles again and move it to the bottom. So now that it starts here, goes around and goes there, but you'll notice it's upside down. So one thing you can do is click on that and click this. This will reverse the text path. So if it's on the bottom, it'll move it to the top. If it's on the top, it'll move it to the bottom. So you want it on the top there, and then move the baseline. So the baseline is what it's on. So you can see the baseline is right on the circle here. It's zero, but I can move the baseline down. You can see the percentage. And I would move it till it touches the top right there. You see that? And make sure you spell the whole word Montana. Maybe give it a space and do USA. Have fun with that. That's text on a path. Hopefully this tip was really helpful for you. The question of the day is, have you used text on a path before? Let me know that in the comments below. And as always, guys, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one. Bye.